And breaking news, America's ambassador to South Korea is in a hospital right now after police say he was slashed with a razor blade. South Korea's YTN News Channel reports Ambassador Mark Lippert was injured on his face and his hands.
You can have a look there and you can see his injured hand and holding the right side of his face. This is a photograph taken obviously just moments afterwards. And none of the injuries life-threatening. The U.S. Embassy says he is in a stable condition, and we're also hearing from a National Security Council spokesperson that the U.S. President Barack Obama has called the ambassador already to tell him that he and his wife, whose name is Robin, are in his thoughts and prayers and to wish him for a very speedy recovery. That just coming out a few minutes ago.
The CNN affiliate YTN reporting the ambassador was about to give a breakfast speech at a public event in Seoul when a person in his 60s attacked the ambassador. Police say they are questioning a suspect. There's no word yet on the motive for the attack.
Correspondent Paula Hancocks is in the South Korean capital where she is based for CNN, joins us now with the very latest. Good to see you there, Paula. Just let's go back to basics and outline to us exactly what we know about what happened.
Well, Michael, we know from an embassy spokesman that Ambassador Lippert was attacked this morning. We know that he is in hospital at this point and is in a stable condition. That's all they can tell us on the record at this point. We do know from police that it was a man in his 50s. They've now corrected themselves. Earlier they said 60s. A man in his 50s who carried out the attack, surnamed Kim. That's the only name they gave us, and of course that's a very common name here in South Korea. They say that he attacked the ambassador with a razor blade and attacked him on his right cheek and his hand, and that would coincide with those pictures you're seeing there of the ambassador. The ambassador was then taken straight to the hospital. At this point, police say they don't know the motive. We do have some local media reports of shouts that were heard, some saying that they wanted the unification of North and South Korea, some saying they were against the joint military drills. We can't confirm this at this point, but the breakfast that the ambassador was attending was actually a breakfast for the reunification of the two Koreas. Now, this is a breakfast event. It is in downtown Seoul, very central, and obviously a very public area. But this has taken many people by surprise. The first time a U.S. ambassador in Seoul has been attacked in this way.